Okay, in this video we're going to be talking about how to set up a document properly for laser cutting in the Fab Lab. Starting in Adobe Illustrator, you're going to want to create a new document for whatever artwork you're creating. At this point, the document size could be the same size as the material you'll be cutting, or in the case of repeating an object multiple times on a piece of material, you can start with a smaller sized file and we can repeat the cuts and processes on the laser cutter when we get the file on the laser cutter software. So I'm going to start with a file that's 5 by 5 inches. What I want to do and make sure here under the Advanced tab is that we specify the color mode right from the get-go to be RGB. And that's important because all of the colors that we specify for the laser cutter need to be in RGB. If your file type happens to be CMYK, even though you specify RGB colors, when the file is saved, they will always be reverted to CMYK or converted to CMYK colors, which will cause a problem in outputting to the laser printer. So starting with an RGB file, we'll click OK. Here's our document. If we look at the color palette here, we can see that there are preset colors already with red, green, and blue, or RGB values. We want to work in pure RGB colors, and I'll show you how to specify those in a second. So in this artwork, we are going to work with a couple of different things, a couple of different objects. Something that will be etched. For example, if we wanted to etch some text, let's bump up the size here so that we can see what our text is going to look like. Let's try something interesting here. And let's make sure the size is large enough so that we can see it. There we go. Okay, so we've placed this text on our artwork, on our artboard, and anything that we see here in a fill, black fill, let's make sure that this is black. We can see RGB 0, 0, 0. Anything with a black fill will be etched. If we wanted to cut shapes on this artboard, then any shapes that we create that we want to cut would have a specific cut color as well. So for example, let's say we'll work with a square, maybe a circle as well, and use our star tool here and create a 5-pointed star. In order to cut these objects, again, depending on the material you're working with, any materials that have a substantial thickness to them that can't be folded, for example, plexiglass or wood, plywood, masonite, you would be using red outlines for your cuts. And to specify that, then we would go to change the fill to none, and we would change the stroke in this case here to full RGB red, so 255 0, 0. And we can see that stroke now strokes this square in red. We also want to specify the weight of the stroke to 0.1 points in thickness. Okay, and we can see that the stroke is now thinned out a little bit, and we can do the same to these objects as well. So we want to specify no fill and a red stroke. And once again, 0.1 points thickness. Okay, so these three objects will now be cut from our material, and this black text will be etched onto the surface of the material. If we're working with a material that is thin enough to be folded and you wish to work with cuts and fold lines, then what we need to do is introduce a third color. And the sequence of colors can be seen in the file attached, and the software will work from top to bottom. First black, then red, then blue, and subsequently through the 16 different stages that are available. In this case, working with something that we would want to cut and fold, we would specify our artwork slightly differently. So let me just remove some of this for the time being, and we're going to work with, again, a rectangle that will be cut, but we want to add some fold or score lines to it. So in order to cut, we always want to make sure that the last step we do is our cut steps. Otherwise, anything done before this would be could possibly fall out of place when cutting prior to another step like etching or engraving fold lines. So let's say we're going to cut this rectangle out around the text, but we also want to be able to fold this. So we're going to create a couple of fold lines here by simply using our line tool and dragging those fold lines out like this. Okay. And what we want to do is specify the outer edges to be a different color. What we're going to use is blue as opposed to red. And as we can see here in the sliders, we specified 00 and 255. The same weight is applied to the cuts. All we're doing here is changing the parameters for the red cuts and the blue cuts in terms of power and speed in which the laser uses to cut these lines. It will follow the vectors as we've outlined them. So they could be straight lines, they could be shapes, they could be curved lines. Regardless, the vectors will be followed by the laser. We just apply more power and a slower speed to execute the cuts, and lower power settings and a faster speed to execute the fold lines. So at this point, the file is prepped and ready to be saved for output. And what we'll do is simply go to the Save menu and save it as an AI file type, Adobe Illustrator. We're going to save it somewhere on a drive that we can walk over to the Fab Lab, a PC formatted jump drive or something like that. We can specify its location here. In this case, desktop is fine. We'll move it to the drive later. Once we hit save, we have options here as to what format or what version we want. Ideally, if you can, save your artwork as Illustrator CS6, and that way the machine, the PC that we use at the other end in the Fab Lab to read this file can read it properly. Click OK and save your artwork. So make sure you check out the rest of our videos located at the Tech Info site at design.yorku.ca/tech_info.